Testing one, two. You can keep talking, that's fine.
Well, howdy.
Howdy.
Thank y'all for coming. You know, before we get started, and I hate to tell you this, but I don't know if y'all stick over the dial. You got to worry about it, all right? Because we're recording. And you know about it, right? A whole lot between songs and stuff, so pay attention.
Mr. Angel and Mr. Sousa for helping us with everything they've done. Thank you to all the choral activities staff. We couldn't do any of this without them. And I'd like to give thanks to our ex officios and to our officers. So I'll introduce myself. I'm Webb Rawson. I'm president of Century Singers. I'm an electronic systems engineering technology major with Is that better? Okay. I'll start over. I'm Webb Rawson. I'm an electronic systems engineering technology major with a minor in cybersecurity from Kingwood, Texas. I'd like to introduce our vice president, Julia Gianelli. She is a wildlife and fisheries sciences major from Melissa, Texas. I'd like to introduce our treasurer, Jonathan Nguyen. He is an economics major from Cypress, Texas. I'd like to introduce our performance manager, Chrissy Elizondo. She is a psychology major with a minor in neuroscience from Fort Worth, Texas. I'd like to introduce our public relations manager. Her name is Maggie Lipscomb. She is a aspiring marketing major from Dallas, Texas. Secretary, her name is Shelby Walker. She is a kinesiology major from Bryan, Texas. And I'd like to introduce our Pollard representative, Whit Alley. He is a BIMS major from Austin, Texas. Let's have a round of applause for them. That's enough from me, so thank you all, and I hope you enjoy the show.
Thank you.
program, but we're going to sing a version of Amazing Grace. And the reason this came about was when they had the bonfire collapse and they had to service after that, they kind of got to the end of the service and it almost thought the energy was so quiet. Nobody really knew what to do. And then somebody out there started singing Amazing Grace. And so from that time on, we included Amazing Grace in the program. We also sing a piece called In Memoriam, but I thought we were going to have money in the future to work on it for the same on Wednesday, and we're not going to have it. So you don't need to hear that. We tried, but we didn't have it. So Amazing Grace.
Amazing grace, how sweet the sound. the battle of Jericho, Joshua, the battle, the battle of Jericho, Joshua,
the battle of Jericho,
the battle of
Jericho,
the battle of
Jericho, the battle of Jericho,
the battle of Jericho, the battle, the battle of Jericho, Joshua, the battle, the battle of Jericho,
the battle of Jericho,
the battle of Jericho,
the battle of Jericho,
the battle of
Jericho, the battle of Jericho,
the battle of Jericho, the battle, the battle of Jericho, Joshua, the battle, the battle of Jericho.
Talk about your kings of Gideon.
Go on, you can talk
about your men of Saul.
Go on, you can talk about
my good old Joshua at the battle of Jericho.
That morning,
Joshua, the battle of Jericho,
the battle of Jericho,
the battle of
Jericho,
the battle of Jericho,
the battle of Jericho,
the battle of Jericho,
the battle, the battle of Jericho, Joshua, the battle, the battle of Jericho.
Battle,
battle, battle, battle, battle, battle, battle, battle, battle, battle, battle, battle, battle, battle, battle, battle, battle, battle, battle, battle, battle, battle, battle, battle, battle, battle, battle, battle, battle, battle, battle, battle, battle, battle, battle, battle, battle, battle, battle, battle, battle, battle, battle, battle, battle, battle, battle, battle, battle, battle, battle, battle, battle, battle, battle, battle, battle, battle, battle, battle, battle, battle, battle, battle, battle, battle, battle, battle, battle, battle, battle, battle, battle, battle, battle, battle, battle, battle, battle, battle, battle, battle, battle, battle, battle, battle, battle, battle, battle, battle, battle, battle, battle, battle, battle, battle, battle, battle, battle, battle, battle, battle, battle, battle, battle, battle, battle, battle, battle, battle, battle, battle, battle, battle, battle, battle, battle, battle, battle, battle, battle, battle, battle, battle, batt
up one May morning so early. I overtook a pretty fair maid, just as the sun was dawning with me rune on red. For the diddle day, what for their diddle I do?
Her stockings white and her boots were bright, and her buckling shone like silver. She had a dark and a rolling black, and her hair hung round her shoulder with me rune on red. For the diddle day, what for their diddle I do?
Somebody to love every day. Tracks, think it is here. Get out of the way!
Howdy everyone, my name is Julia Gianelli and I'm serving as this spring semester's vice president. Whoop. I'm a little nervous, to put it lightly, so I'm going to be reading from my phone just a little bit. So I would like to welcome you all to our annual spring concert and thank you for either your newfound support or your continued support for this wonderful choir. I hope each and every one of you leave here today knowing fully how special this choir is and what it means to its members. This concert would not have been possible without the hard work of the choir, Travis Angel and Miguel Sousa, and thank you, Michael Vaughn, for facilitating us being able to use this beautiful space. Now, welcome Jared Campbell, former Century Singer and bass section leader, for a few wise words.
How's everyone doing? So as she mentioned, I'm Jared Campbell. I am a former Century Singer and former bass section leader of this choir, and this choir is very close to my heart. Now, I'm pretty sure we're all tired of hearing about the pandemic, right? But let's go ahead and talk about the pandemic, right? So this past year, it's been an irregular one, to say the least, for the whole world. For many, this pandemic has postponed people's goals and aspirations, the things they're working for. For other people like myself, it's really just given me an excuse to be lazier. I've been able to clock in from my bed at 8 o'clock, you know, at any Zoom conference or Teams users in here. Yeah. But for other people like these students right here, nothing about their college experience is getting to be postponed or pushed back or done over, you know. These graduating seniors, they're not getting to do a makeup year without COVID. You know, there's no do-overs for this group. I think maybe the easier thing would have done to be done would have been to not have choir this past year. But I do think that Travis Angel and Miguel and this staff knew that these students were incredibly passionate, not just about making music, but about the camaraderie that they have with one another. And that wasn't something that could just be put off for another year or just canceled entirely. It means too much to them. These students had no intention of leaving their Century Singers tenures in 2019, and I can't blame them. These students have worked hard and fought through adversity to be where they are today. And if you're a parent, I would say you should be very proud of your students, not only their perseverance, but their passion for something artistic and something beautiful, such as making music together. I think I can speak for all former Century Singers when I say that we find it truly inspiring what you guys have done the past year. And I will leave you with this. As a musician myself, not only from this choir, but in my own personal time, I can say from the bottom of my heart that there are few feelings that are worth fighting for in this world. And I think one of them is making music as a team. And now, Mr. Angel.
We were one of the few SEC schools, I think I've told the students this several times, that actually had choir because we have new facilities, we had the space to have that. And so we're very, very fortunate in that. This is the time, I'd like to take this time to thank our ex-officials for the work they've done this semester. I'd probably need a pay raise if I didn't have these hardworking members to tackle all the various tasks for the choir. As I call your name, please stand so we can recognize each of you for your dedication to make this choir the best it can be. Our librarian was Caitlin. Information technology aide, Uman. Fundraising committee chair, Ross. Farmers liaison, and he's done a lot with this year, is Miguel. And then four people that really make a lot of difference in how we sound, the music we are able to tackle and do. I mean, think of the 10,000 words in that last song, you know, and the pitches that go along with it is our section leaders. Soprano was Kita. Alto is Maria. Tenor is Eric. And our bass was Lane. Some of their sections are more passionate than others. My officers, these very unique individuals I'm about to announce have put up with me and my shenanigans all year. This is the point in the program where I thank them for surviving the journey. In all seriousness, these individuals have been on a mission from day one to transform this choir into something to be proud of. Thanks to my fearless leadership, who wrote this? Thanks to my fearless leadership, a lot of great things were accomplished, and I'm happy that I got to witness these young people do great things for the cause that they are passionate about. And, you know, the thing is, the officers worked very hard at communicating with me, coming in and visit to talk over stuff. People that had to have, because we are a very social group, and to figure out how to get people together and meet all the criteria that A&M put upon us is very, you know, some of them are geniuses to figure it out, honestly. Don't you wish you had bought stock in Zoom last year? Another story. Officer Stan, as I call your name, so we can recognize each of you for your dedication to make this choir the best it can be. And understand that I just appreciate the support you gave me through the year. I appreciate the way you always had my back. And I appreciate just the positive nature that you always had in choir. you know, one of our rules was to have a good time, and these guys really bought into that, to have a good time, and because music should be fun to do. Our pollard representative is Whit. And Whit had one of those unique challenges. We always do a pollard book every year so the pollards can get to know everybody. So now we can't do a book because then that would transfer COVID. So then he has to learn how to do it online. And we have a retreat so everybody can get to know each other. And we can't do the retreat like usual. I mean, Whit's one of those that it was amazing because he did like 15 different ways before it finally worked out, you know. Our secretary, Shelby Walker. Shelby is in charge of our TNFT. That's a Thursday night fun time. And is that right?
Thursday night fun
thing. Yeah, okay. Fun things. And where we get together to play games or do all these things. And so she's had to come up with ways to do it on Zoom and do it online. And so she's another one of those people that did it 15 different ways before it finally would get approved. I lost my spot. Thank you, Shelby. Public Relations Manager is Maggie. And Maggie is responsible for the publicity and like our background and stuff like that. So, and she proofreads the stuff before I hand it out. Thank goodness, because golly, I make a lot of mistakes, okay? Our Performance Manager is Chrissy. And Chrissy is one of her responsibilities is showcase, and she's another one of those people that had to figure out five ways to do it, and finally was able to do it online. And yeah, I'm proud of you. Okay, our treasurer is Jonathan. Jonathan is my favorite because I hate handling money. And so I so appreciate that I have somebody that will take care of that and I don't have to worry about it. So thank you so much, Jonathan. Our vice president is Julia. And then our president is Webb. Thank you, Webb. So I appreciate their leadership. Come here.
So I would now like to take this time to recognize the few who have achieved perfect attendance by attending rehearsal when they're not in class, because let's be honest, it's not easy as a college student. So first we'd like to recognize Elizabeth Culpepper. Andrew Hickey, who's not here today, but woo! George Cupper. Yes, Olivia Cabell. Caitlin Sulak. And Lauren Alt. So a round of applause to you all because, you know, it's a difficult time to attend choir sometimes. And Mr. Angel. Oh wait, no, okay. So next we will be giving out Lifesaver Awards. These are awards that officers give to people who have really encouraged and helped us in a time where we need it as an officer, whether it's in a personal situation or with choir. So with that, Whit, you're up, buddy.
Hi there. All right, so the person receiving this award, since the moment that I met them, has always been a place of peace and calm during the semester. They always create a space where everyone feels comfortable and accepted, and any room that this person is in is sure to have many laughs and smiles. They are a great example of a good person with a caring heart. Whether it's ping pong until 4 a.m., Smash Bros. Until 5 a.m., deep talks until 6 a.m., or none of that if this person is busy taking care of animals. This person is always making me laugh and take a couple of good calming deep breaths. My time in Century Singers would not be what it has been without my wonderful, supporting, animal-loving Century Singers father, Lane Scroggs.
I'm getting up for a reason. Oh, geez. I'm short. I have to lower the mic a little bit. There we go. My lifesaver is someone very dear to me. I've known them. Oh, let me step back. I heard the feedback. Oh, geez. Sorry. This person, I've known them for a very long time, since about middle school, truly. They are very near and dear to me. They've dealt with my shenanigans, and I've spilled all the beans to them when I needed a vent, because I know they won't tell anyone, because I can trust them with like my whole life, more or less. This person has led to me meeting other people from schools before and creating connections I never thought I would ever create, and helped me create the wonderful friend group I now have called the Brothers. Very cute. So my lifesaver award goes to my best friend, Madeline Giles.
Hi, I'm Maggie Lipscomb. So my lifesaver is someone who's one of the most important people in my life. This person has more generosity and kindness than anyone I could even imagine. Time and time again, they've pulled through for me. Even if I thought it was going to be impossible, they were there. You know, I met this person not even in Century Singers. I met this person at a pop school social with my honors organization, and personally I think that just means that it was fate, and I can't even believe how this person could have impacted my life. You know, she's always running to my rescue, and I just love her very, very much. So my lifesaver is Keita Rao.
But I lost my phone, so I'm just going to speak from the phone. My lifesaver is one of my closest friends in choir. And she is somebody who is constantly showing her kind heart to people, including myself. And she's always been there for me, whether that be just laughing or talking or singing since we first met in choir freshman year. She's someone who I know is always there for me. Sorry, I'm like, I love her so much. Maria Creamer, you're my lifesaver.
Howdy.
Howdy.
So my name is Jonathan Wynn, and my lifesaver, well actually, when I first went to college, you're free. You know, you have nobody to tell you what to do, except for maybe your parents threatening you to, you know, like, I'm paying for your college, so you better do well. But really, there's nobody to tell you what to do. And you know, I was kind of a free spirit, a lost soul, and I kind of needed that discipline. And this person is honestly the most hardworking, most disciplined, most persevering person I know, from feeding me every Sunday for like 2 years, to being the person that I can text at 6 a.m. when I definitely was a little too degenerate, and ask them, hey, can you wake me up in 2 hours? And you know, he's gonna do it, but he'll judge you a little bit. And he still loves you anyways. So my lifesaver goes to Miguel Sousa.
comedy again. My lifesaver is someone who not only has supported me throughout my entire time in Century Singers, both physically and emotionally, but also supported me as a mentor and a best friend. From our weekly sleepovers to when we survived the ice storm of 2021 together, you've always been a source of comfort and friendship. Thank you for encouraging me to be vocal about my feelings and facilitating a way for me to grow as an individual. Melina, thank you for being a part of my life, and thank you for allowing me to be a part of yours.
Howdy.
Howdy.
Now, when Julia asked me a couple weeks ago who I wanted to choose as my lifesaver, it was a no-brainer. This person has been by my side ever since I got to A&M, whether it's been playing video games, cooking extravagant things, playing Dungeons & Dragons. This person's been there for me. They've been a positive role model, and they've been one of my biggest inspirations in my my time as a choir officer. So Robbie Reyes, this one's for you.
What is up? Just a sec, okay. Many of you don't know, this will be my last semester here, and you know, I have moved a lot. I'm from Portugal, I don't know if you heard it. And you start reflecting about what you created in where you are. And you know, this person, it's Mr. Angel, I'm just going to say right now. But Mr. Angel came to A&M 2016, and I remember him knocking at my door, my office, and I see this extravagant man, you know, 6 feet tall man with this country accent, and I was like, who is this person? Mr. Angel has, many of you Century Singers don't know, but Jared and some of you know, it was a rough time for Century Singers back then. And Mr. Angel saved us all. Mr. Angel, this is, you know, I have to go deep because to explain what I'm trying to say. But you know, my father was never very close to me, and I've always had to take care of my sister and my mom. And so, you know, from early on, I really had to be the man. And people now say, oh, you should not say what a man is, blah, blah, blah. The man, being a man, for me means someone that no matter what, you know, they have your back and they protect you. And I think a lot of the students know that. Mr. Angel, I mean, it doesn't need to say anything. You just know that you have this man protecting you. And, you know, I'm seeing some faces nodding. If he hugs you, it's like the world is hugging you. It's just, you know, just such an incredible experience. And I hate hugs. No, I like the hugs, whatever. But, you know, Mr. Angel, you have been so important to us. You are like a dad to me, even if you're really old. I remember one time telling him, Mr. Angel, Travis, I hope I can be half of the man that you are, because, you know, your moral values, the sense of being a good person, it's very hard to get that from a lot of people. And, you know, you are just a hero for a lot of us. You're a hero for me. This man has drove me nuts. I mean, he is, you know, I have, OMG, I've wanted to kill him several times, but, and he knows that, and a lot of you know it. But, you know, I don't like to say I love you very lightly, but I love this man to the death. And he said a few days ago, oh, I don't think you're going to remember me. Oh, you're wrong, Mr. Angel. You'll always be in my heart. Your family will be in my heart. And I'm so, thank you so much for what you do to me and to all of us. And you're just such a good person. And I really hope I can be half of the man that you are. But just, you know, personality and values, because you're getting a little chubby, okay? Anyway, thank you for being our lifesaver award. You're my lifesaver, and you'll always be my lifesaver. And I love you so, so much, and I'm going to miss you so dearly. So thank you for everything that you've done for us and for me.
He could have left out that part about half the person. Now we're going to recognize two individuals who have been voted on by the choir as the single most respected and hardworking Outstanding Pollard of the Year and Outstanding Member of the Year. Our Outstanding Pollard of the Year this year is Lily. Come on down. Outstanding Member of the Year is Julia.
Okay, so every year we give out an award that honors somebody who isn't in Century Singers, but we want to include them because they've done so much for our organization. And so every year the choir decides on a person that goes above and beyond, not only for a single person, but the choir in general. Not only has this lovely individual always opened her home to those of us who are unable to go home for holidays like Easter, Thanksgiving, Christmas, and always hosted a beautiful end of the semester celebration with many desserts, including that key lime pie. She has also supported us by attending our concerts and fun activities like retreat, and also reminding Mr. Angel that our concert is on Saturday and not Sunday, and always providing a true and kind presence. So this year, we would like to have Charlotte Angel join us as an honorary Century Singer. So this concert, you've noticed me talk a lot about Miguel. So I'm gonna talk about him a little bit more. So this year, we're doing something a little different. The Officer Board has decided to integrate a new award, never before seen, in dedication to this individual who is very special to our choir. We have created a service-oriented award dedicated to this man who has been living out his life in service of the environment, the community, and also this choir. His love and compassion for his dogs and keeping the community clean is something to always be commended and respected. He's a light in this choir, and this award will not be given every year, but when a member has proven themselves to show the same love of service that Miguel has. This year, Miguel will be distinguished as the inaugural recipient of the Sousa Service Award. Miguel, we love and appreciate you more than words could ever be capable of conveying. So thank you for everything you've done to make this choir better. So I want to thank everyone for taking the time out of their day to attend or watch this concert. This choir has been everything to me throughout my college experience, and I'm thankful for each and every one of you for being a part of it. Your leadership for the next year will do an amazing job, and I look forward to looking back and seeing how all of you have grown as adults and as an organization. To the friends and family We are so thankful for you and your support. Oh, jeez. And time, and hope we see you again at our next concert. We are not music majors, and we do this because we love singing and the people we sing with. So fittingly, we're gonna wrap up our little award ceremony with a song, Old Irish Blessing. At this time, we'd like to invite all current and former Century singers to join us. One last singing of Old Irish Blessing.
Thank you. yes?
He had my glasses.